Why are Barry Allen's real children ignored on the Flash TV show? Did the series drastically change his origin story? And what's the deal with Wally West? I'm Dylan, and I'm your host to the Speed Force Effects. Barry Allen's appearance. To be fair, comic book accuracy isn't such a big thing nowadays. After all, look at how Superman finally figured out that he must wear his red underwear under his suit. As long as the actor selected for the part is true to the character's essence, most fans are okay with it. Alright, maybe not with all the vocal trolls on Twitter, but you get the point. Still, that doesn't take away from the fact that Barry Allen has been portrayed as blonde and buff in the comics, from his first appearance in Showcase Issue 4 to the current Rebirth continuity in DC Comics. Barry has always been seen as fair-haired and like he'd hit the gym whenever he had a moment, especially the treadmill, nudge nudge wink wink. On the Flash TV series though, actor Grant Gustin is dark-haired and not quite as muscular as his comic book counterpart. In a past interview with The Hollywood Reporter, Grant revealed that the team behind the series was looking for something else, something beyond the appearance of the character in the comics. He said the following, "They were looking for somebody who encompassed the heart of Barry Allen, and at first, I didn't realize I did. Now that I've explored the character, the comics, read the scripts, and talked to the producers, I understand why I got this role." Considering how the show is set to enter its seventh season and still remains popular among the fanbase, it just proves that the casting agents did the right thing and chose the right actor for the part. Not every superhero needs to look like they're capable of bench-pressing their entire fanbase, right? The Flash's origin. When the audience first saw Barry appear in Season 2 of Arrow, fans lost their minds! Finally, superhero TV was evolving to the point where it could become a shared universe and feature crossovers with big characters. More importantly, the episode also gave us a tease of Barry's transformation into the Flash. However, we had to wait for the first season of the Scarlet Speedster's solo series to find out all the details of how he came to be. In the Arrowverse, Barry gets the powers of the Speed Force after Star Lab's particle accelerator malfunctions, sending dark matter into the clouds. This sets off a chain of events, causing a lightning storm above the Central City Police Station that results in Barry being electrocuted. The accident ends up giving him his super speed while turning countless others into metahumans. While lightning did play a part in the Flash's comic book origin, it was slightly different than what we saw on the TV show. In the comics, the lightning bolt struck a case of unknown chemicals that splattered all over Barry. It was the combination of the lightning and chemicals that gave him his powers, not a particle accelerator. That being said, the Flash's origins have been tweaked with every comic book reboot, so a particle accelerator isn't completely out of the realm of possibility. Truth be told, it does actually make a lot more sense when you think about it. By its very definition, a particle accelerator is meant to propel charged particles to high speeds and energies, so why wouldn't it have an effect on human cells too? Whew! But now that's a deep science question that only Bill Nye can answer for us. The foster parent. On the Flash TV show, Barry's parents still played a pivotal role in his superhero development. After Henry Allen was wrongfully arrested for the murder of his wife, Nora, Joe West took in the young Barry and raised him as his own. The two share an extremely tight bond, and he acts as Barry's moral compass, especially when the going gets tough and the superhero has a crisis of identity. In many ways, he's to Barry what Uncle Ben was to Peter Parker and Spider-Man. And look, everyone who watches The Flash wishes they had a caring dad like Joe West. Despite having a stressful job chasing around strange villains in Central City, he's always there for his kids with an inspiring word or thoughtful comment that pushes them to be better people. It's one of those special Joe-ments that fans truly love to see. The thing is, Joe is an entirely new character created for the TV show, and he never existed in comic book continuity. In fact, in the original comics, Iris West was adopted by a man called Ira West. Change isn't always a bad thing though, as Joe's inclusion in the series truly injected a strong parental energy into the show. Jesse L. Martin, who plays the character, agrees, telling Vanity Fair, "I knew that I would be doing a lot of parenting on the show. I just didn't know what the effect would be on us as actors, on the show in general, and on the audience. We've gotten to do some really amazing things as far as fathers and sons and fathers and daughters." In the case of Joe West, this is one deviation from the comics that was undoubtedly for the better. And you'll be hard-pressed to find people who disagree. The curious case of Harrison Wells. There's no denying that Tom Cavanagh deserves a lot more recognition than he gets. He's a sensational and versatile actor who hardly puts a wrong foot and brings a special kind of energy to every role of his. It's no surprise, then, that only he could perform all the different versions of Harrison Wells from the multiverse. Whether as the main villain or the comic relief, you know you're in for a good time when he's on the screen. What's even more remarkable is that Harrison Wells and all his infinite variations were created solely for the TV show. Yet, it's almost impossible to imagine a Flash universe where he isn't a part of the proceedings. Of course, most fans remember Season 1's version of the character best, especially with the huge plot twist where he turned out to be the Reverse Flash. If you recall, it was Eobard Thawne who killed Wells and took his likeness for himself, while also torturing Barry for an entire season. He's a multitasking kind of villain. And it seems it's that version of the character that Tom Cavanagh also holds dearest, as he revealed to Den of Geek that he looks forward to playing the Reverse Flash. He said, "If you look closely, almost every year that yellow suit's coming on. That's the largest shadow that the characters I play cast. That's the reason I'm on the show, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for that opportunity. The Joker has gotta show up for Batman, Luther's gotta show up for Superman, and Reverse Flash has to show up for Flash." He isn't wrong, because he's still the one Flash villain that every fan considers the biggest threat to Barry and Team Flash. All the others are merely derivatives of the Reverse Flash, and it shows. Barry and Iris's kids. It's natural for the children of superheroes to follow in their parents' footsteps and become defenders of justice too. It's expected and something that would be really out of character if they ignored their true calling. While Barry and Iris are still enjoying the newlywed life, the Flash's desire to break every single timeline has seen them receive a glimpse of the world of tomorrow. In the not-too-distant future, they become parents to Nora West Allen, who, drumroll please, is a speedster and time traveler like Daddy Dearest. Interestingly, Barry and Iris never had a daughter named Nora in the comics. Instead, they were parents to twins, Dawn and Dawn Allen, also known as the Tornado Twins. From the name, you can kinda figure out that they have the same powers as their dad. Nora's origin is basically a loose adaptation of the twins. After Barry's death in the Crisis on Infinite Earths event, the already pregnant then Iris moved to the 30th century where she gave birth to their children. Her plan was to keep them away from the superheroics and allow them to live a normal life without the Justice League and other superpowered beings. However, the twins caught the speedster bug and found themselves zipping across timelines into the wider DC universe. For diehard Flash fans, they'll know that Dawn is also the father of Bart Allen, also known by the superhero name of Impulse. A popular speedster with fast feet and an even faster tongue, he's been a part of DC superhero teams such as Young Justice, the Teen Titans, and the Legion of Superheroes. Oddly enough, it's a common misconception that Bart is Barry's son when he's actually his grandson. So, hopefully this clears things up once and for all. With the Flash speeding into new Earths and different timelines, we wouldn't be too surprised if the Tornado Twins pop up on the TV show at some point. After all, the Arrowverse uses the multiverse as an excuse every time it decides to retcon something or the other, so anything's possible here. Will the real Wally West please stand up? For a generation of comic book fans, Wally West is the Flash. After starring in the new Teen Titans as Kid Flash, Wally took over for his Uncle Barry as the DC Universe's main Flash after Crisis on Infinite Earths. Years later, the new 52 comic book reboot introduced another version of Wally West, who was actually the original Wally's cousin. It's all a little confusing and more like Days of Our Lives than anyone cares to admit, but the point is this. Wally's an important part of the Flash mythology. On the TV show, Wally was introduced as Iris's younger brother, who gained the same superpowers as Barry and became Kid Flash. Unfortunately, he didn't stick around on the show for too long, instead departing for a main role on Legends of Tomorrow. He was a regular for one season before also exiting that series. It surprised a lot of fans at the time, especially considering Wally's overall importance to the Flash family and the DC universe. As it turns out, Kid Flash's disappearance from the Arrowverse was due to Kenan Lonsdale's rising star in Hollywood. In an Instagram post, the actor said, "I've changed a lot in the past year, and for infinite reasons, my perspective on life and what I want from it now is just completely different. Because of that, my heart told me it was the right time to continue my journey on an unknown path, and I'm so damn grateful to both shows for honoring and respecting that with me." The question still remains though, was the TV show's Wally the real Wally or just another Wally? I'm confused just even thinking about it. Naturally, there are many other differences between the Flash TV show and the comics. Which are some of the biggest ones that you've spotted? And do you think that the show will continue to deviate from the source material? Thanks for watching, and let us know what you think in the comments section down below. And while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe.